Life Speakers Radio Show, a show that will encourage, give hope, and speak life to inspire and motivate those who want to refresh their passion for life and to live it to the fullest. Feel free to tune in and listen to the inspiring words from Life Speaker Sharon Dotson, who speaks life the way God gives it to her, and the guests that will assist her in bringing hope, motivation, and encouragement to you along life's journey, to understand that everything will work out for good, to help you survive and thrive the test of life that may come your way to walk in destiny and purpose. Sweet light, when the sun will shine and you don't know why. Look into the eyes of the broken hearted. Watch it go like as soon as you speak hope.
Hello, 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 hello. We are back. Sharon Dotson and
her son Wayne ID.
We're back today and we're here to speak some life to you today, to make your life better, to inspire you, and to give you a hope like never before. We are excited today because we are going to have a great discussion with you today. We want to talk about today strongholds in our lives. Now that's something. What you think about that, Wayne?
Oh yeah, that's cool. That's straight, Mom. Let's do it.
Let's do it. So, Wayne, I'm gonna let you tell our radio world about what we talked about concerning strongholds that come in your life, through your life, and then we're gonna have a way to let them go.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Well, for anybody who's not familiar with, you know, what a stronghold is, well, a stronghold is a way of thinking and feeling that has developed a life of its own in a person. It might be a rut of depression or reoccurring unbelief or habitually bad temper. Also, the type of stronghold, like especially concerning this situation, a spiritual stronghold, is anything, yes, which is anything that has power over you.
Yes.
Ideally, it's Jesus. But throughout our lives, we will all come up against strongholds that are desires of our flesh.
Amen. And just like you said, Wayne, ideally, it's supposed to be Jesus as the person that keeps us and covers us and keeps things from causing havoc and grief in our lives. But because we get so far from Jesus, these strongholds, they pull on us. They pull in us and they come to us and try to offset us. And Wayne, I want you to give us some examples of stronghold, because of the fact we let go of Jesus' hand and the strongholds take over our lives.
Oh, yeah, most definitely, Mom. Well, okay, the examples are, there's bitterness or forgiveness, which is you think of revenge or feel hatred towards another individual.
Yes.
And you're often angry and feel resentful. Another one is obsessive worry or fear, which is worrying about all the parents out there. If you're worrying about your kids,
yeah,
or individual people, like if you're worried about your future or finances, like what we talked about last week with finances and life with Mr. Carlos.
Yes.
You worry about finances to the point where it steals your joy.
Yes.
And then there's also, there's jealousy.
Mm-hmm.
In case y'all wondering the perfect definition for this, you know, it's the thoughts or feelings of insecurity of people and their fear, inadequacy, and disgusted.
Amen.
Yeah, and there's also more addiction, which is also the substances,
yes,
or even being addicted to attention or praise.
Well, you know, Wayne, this sounds like everything that is a stronghold has taken the place of God and caused us to get wayward from God. And not only that, but to get so to the point that God wants to keep us from all of this. And these things have drawn themselves to us because we did not draw near to Christ. Strongholds have to be broken. And today we're going to tell you and minister you how we have to pull those strongholds down. They've got to come down because they are causing destruction in our lives. They are causing pain in our lives. They are causing things that we don't really have to go through in our lives. But because we have allowed strongholds to come into our lives, it has taken us far from God and what His protection will do for us and keep us from. So we got to get the strongholds, pull them down, pull them down, pull them down. We've got to. And we, Life Speakers, are going to talk to you and show you and give you ideas and ways to do it, because we have to let these strongholds go, because we will be great in our future. We will have what God says we will have and be who God says we will be, because we will be free from the strongholds that are keeping us bound. Strongholds that are keeping us from getting the blessings that God has for us, like bitterness and fear. Fear has torments. So we're going to stop tormenting ourselves and let the fear go and step out and trust God, because that's a way where fear has to leave. That's a way where strongholds have to be pulled down and broken off of our lives. Right, Wayne?
Yes, ma'am.
What you think about that?
Oh,
we
yes.
got to change.
Yes, got to put change in. Do whatever you got to do to write like goals or anything, any bad vibes or good vibes, any bad images or good images that happen in your life, or anything you want as successfully.
Yes.
To shine out to the world and also within God, you got to do it. If it takes change, then you got to face up to it, face up to the challenge to it.
Yes. And also, a mental wall is resistance is resistance in the case of a stronghold. It's time to pull down these strongholds by presenting the truth of God, God's word, and allowing the Holy Spirit to reshape our thoughts, our attitude, and our perception. It's time for us to have to be transformed, and it's time for transformation. What you think about that, Wayne? It's time for us to be transformed and renewed in our minds. You know, because it's time for change, y'all. It's time for us to do something different.
Of course.
To get these strongholds out of our lives. Right now, I'm going to read a scripture. Wayne, I got a scripture I want to share with the radio world.
Yes, ma'am. Go ahead, Mom.
And the scripture is 2 Corinthians 10th chapter and the 3rd, 4th, and 5th verse. And it says, "For we walk in the flesh, but we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God, with the pulling down of strongholds, casting down every imagination and every high place that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bring into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ." We're going to take all the negative thoughts away. We are going to replace them with what God is telling us in our lives to do and to be, and offset every attempt of the enemy to allow the strongholds to capture us. But we will not allow it any longer. We don't want you to allow it any longer either. We're going to come with you now with a song called "Pulling Down Strongholds," and I hope that it blesses your life in Jesus' name.
And then whenever you want me to pull in, whenever you want to pull in and talk about other examples.
You gonna read this now?
I did.
Okay, I'm saying, okay.
Already ready to let you know.
What is this?
That's more examples.
Oh, okay. You want to give us some more definitions? I mean, some more ways?
Yeah.
Stronghold?
Yeah, more examples. Those are examples. More examples. Those are new examples.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that what you want me to do? And was this the right thing? And was this the right, is that what you want me to do?
Yeah.
Is this the right thing when you asked me about it?
Yeah, definitely.
Thank you.
The Pace? Pace Sisters? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Amen. Lord, help us pull down these strongholds, these strongholds of disobedient children, stronghold of false accusers, strongholds of, oh, so many more things. Wayne, you want to give us some more examples of pulling down the, of the things we need to pull down, which are our strongholds? We're going to get rid of these strongholds.
Oh, yes. There's also, there's lust, adultery, meaning less intimate encounters.
Yes.
Also, there's also professionalism, which requires you and it drives you to control.
Control and spirits. That's right. Yes.
Of course. And there's another one is selfishness.
Selfishness.
Which, yes, which provides a fragile ego.
That's good, Wayne.
And there's also despair, which is complaining attitude or low confidence that prevents you from living for God. And there's also include a discontentment, which is a lack of satisfaction with one's possessions, status, and other situations. Longing, and also it means longing for something better than a present situation.
Present situation, longing for something better. And you know, aren't you tired of being busted and disgusted? Sick and tired of where you are? Discontented? It's time, y'all, to pull down these strongholds that have kept us bound, that have kept us from hearing God, has drove us far away from Him so that we can't get the blessings that He has for us. And that's all we're saying today. God's will for our lives is to be free from negative emotions. And these are negative emotions. These are negative feelings, negative things that have come into our lives that have caused us hurt and pain and driven us far away from God. And also that have been holding us hostages and holding us back from being the greatness that God has ordained for us to be. These negative emotions and being inferior or feeling inferior because we are not in the will of God. You know, anything can happen to us. We are susceptible to anything that the enemy throws our way. When we allow the strongholds to come into our lives, we have to get them out of our lives. We will pull down the strongholds. We will live a strong and abundant and confident life, because that's what Christ wants us to do. We'll be free from strongholds in our lives. This is our time to pull down strongholds and to make a difference in our lives so that we will see it and others will see it. And in order to let the strongholds go, we have to let go of unforgiveness. Wayne, what you think about letting go of unforgiveness? So many people hold unforgiveness in their hearts because of being angry, yeah, because of not wanting to forgive others, yeah, because of hurt that has been probably going on in their whole lives, and they just won't let it go. What you think about that?
I mean, yes, forgiveness is not for that other person who hurt you. It's for yourself.
That's right.
Because you can't, don't live your life being mad and angry at something. Because you can't move forward if you,
that's right,
if you are living your life angry, yeah, and thinking about how whatever happened, what that person did to you.
Exactly.
At the end of the day, how you going to move forward? How you going to be happy in life? How you going to ever move forward
let
in your life?
Let
you got to let that go and let it free you.
Exactly.
Even if that person don't want to apologize or anything that caused hurt or harm to you, just say, you know what, I forgive you. Or even did, because I did it myself.
Yeah. Me too.
A lot of people, we all been hurt. Mm-hmm. We all been lied to.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, you got to say, just even say to yourself, you know what? If a person did me wrong, but I'm going to do the right thing.
Yes.
I'm just be like, you know what? I forgive you.
And that is so Christ-like, yes, also. Yes. You know, because sometimes, and like you said, we've all had those kind of experiences where we've been so hurt and didn't want to forgive.
Yeah.
But because we have to know that Christ is wanting us to forgive, not for them, but for ourselves.
Of course.
Because forgiving others will allow you, or will unlock the blessings that God has ordained for your life. But if you get locked up just because you won't forgive, you're going to miss some great things that God has in store for you.
Mm-hmm.
You have to let it go. Also, we want to let go the guilt. Let go the guilt. Yeah, you might have messed up in your past. You might have not been the best person in your past. But hey, that was your past.
Yeah.
Let it go.
Move forward.
Let the guilt go. Maybe you wasn't the best mother. Yeah. Maybe you wasn't the best father. Maybe you wasn't the best child.
Or the best friend.
Let it go.
Anybody who you weren't be the best of, like, you got to let it go. You got to, like, don't let a certain situation, like I said before,
yes,
don't let whatever past situation, don't let that control your future.
Exactly.
Don't let that, any stuff that happened to you in the past, and even don't even bring it up.
That's right.
You've been through some stuff,
yeah,
but you ain't got to bring it up all the time.
That's right.
Because that can kind of drive people away.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever you've been through, if you have to, get yourself some help.
Anything
that's traumatizing or hurt you emotionally, physically, and mentally,
yes, yes,
you gotta get you some help.
Yeah, and just like I said earlier, Wayne, a mental wall of resistance,
mm-hmm,
can destroy your life.
Oh, yeah.
It can take charge over your life. You know, that's why we got to keep our mind on heavenly things. Keep our mind stayed on Jesus. And you know, I'm not saying that as a cliche. I'm saying that because it helps you to stay in your right mind. Because, you know, the mind is a terrible thing when it's not in accordance to what God's will is for your life. And you are not allowing the Holy Spirit to guard your mind. Because thoughts will come into your mind that will bring strongholds. Thoughts will come into your mind that will allow you to do things you know you shouldn't be doing. You know, so it's now time for us to let these things go. Let the regret go. You might have regrets. We all have thought about them or said that we haven't.
Hey.
But you know what? You can't do nothing about what you've done.
Yes.
But you can move forward to your future.
And you can learn that, like whatever that situation was or mistake was, you can learn from that and try to present that to the future and try to coordinate it.
Exactly. And I'm so glad you said that, Wayne, yes. Because when you have regrets, it makes you a prisoner of your future, and it will steal your joy.
Yeah, because I remember how I tell you that back then I used to wish I can go back and like do this and that, but then you'd be
because everything has a purpose. Everything will allow you to know what you need to do and what you don't need to do in your next trial or test or whatever comes your way. Yes. These things come, or they are supposed to come to make us stronger, to make us better, so that when they come again, because the enemy don't have nothing new, he's going to come with the same stuff. Yes. Have you noticed that, Wayne? The enemy comes with the same thing in our lives. Right. The thing is when you recognize that you're ready for him. Yeah, I'm ready. Come on with it, because I'm going to defeat you. Yes. Every time.
And he always used anything or anybody to come your way, try to destroy you.
That's right.
And it's sad. And also with mistakes, like, you know, I guess when people say that, or when somebody asks, like on the movie, I don't know if you saw this month, movie called 13 Going on 30. It was about this this girl who had a 13th birthday party, and she was planning to have all the kids from her school, even the popular kids. But they were trying to play a joke on her or something like that. And some magical thing happened. Mm. She made a wish. Mm. And then she woke up next day 30. And then she was like, oh, my God, I got this. And everything's happening to me. And then when she went to go talk to her mother, she had a heart-to-heart conversation with her mother and asked her, Mom, if you could have a do-over on anything, what would it be? And her mother said, honestly, nothing.
Nothing.
Because if I hadn't made the mistakes I made before then, I wouldn't even learn from them.
Exactly. Because trials and tests come to make you strong. And then even though you don't pass certain tests, you can always go back when it comes or when things happen and know, because you've been through it and you might didn't pass that test, the test of life, you know now what to do because of where you've been and what you've learned from your mistakes. That is so good, Wayne. That is so good. People, we're just here to tell you, to speak life to you, and to tell you that because you might have not did everything so right, and because you allowed the strongholds to make you angry, bitter, envious, jealous, frustrated, insecure, and inferior to others, you don't have to stay there. You can change these things. Now is the perfect time. We are going to pull down these strongholds in our lives, and we want you to do it also, because these things will keep us from the great and bright future that the Lord has for us, from the destiny and purpose that we can walk in if we just let all of the strongholds of the enemy, let them go. Don't even allow him to put them back in our lives ever again. We want to break that. We're going to break it. We're going to let it go. We're going to break these things and never allow them to engulf us anymore, because we are going to be free from strongholds. We are going to be free to see what God has for us, free to see the transformation that he will do when we let him go and be willing to let him come in and stay with us and reshape us, our lives, and even more, give us a bright and awesome future. We want to share this song with you now. And it's called Something Has to Break. Something has to break in our lives, in your life. And we're going to do it. We're going to make sure you do it. Move your way. Something has to break. Take it on every night. Set the wrong thing right. Cause when you have your way, something has to break. Something has to break. Yeah. Thank you. God, we believe your word. We believe that you will do it. You will have your way. Holy Spirit, have your way. We believe you will do it. We believe you will lead us through it. We believe you will get us to it. Right now, God, have your way. Have your way, Lord, in the lives of the ones that are listening on this radio on today. Lord God, break down everything that is not like you in them. And even more, allow them to see what you have in store for them. We come to you today, Live Speakers Radio Show, Sharon Dotson and
Wayne ID,
to tell you it's your time. It's time for destiny and purpose in your life. And let the strongholds go. Pull them down. Pull them out of your life, every one of them. And allow the Holy Spirit to break everything in your life that's not like him. And bring forth a new life for you. Take it in stride. Believe me, it will work for you. Do it. Try it. And watch God. We are so honored to have you today on our show. Look forward to hearing us again on next Friday. Live Speakers Radio Show, where we come here to encourage you, to inspire you, and to give you hope for a bright future that you will walk in Jesus' name. Have a wonderful day. Be blessed.
Yeah, appreciate y'all listening. Much love. Y'all take it easy and be safe.
Awesome.